loved in worldly acclaim. He had half of the alphabet tagged on to his name. And he eulogized formulas I didn't understand. Seems the universe fitted quite well in his hand. He marveled at all of the wonders he'd found, intricate patterns, designs that astound, and he stoked up the altar of wisdom with glee. There was much to discover, and I had to agree. And as I listened and watched, what confounded me more? Wasn't the theories, but the fact he was sure that in all of his findings the appropriate stance was that somehow these marvels had happened by chance. There was a woman in Russia and I don't know her name. She had no education and no worldly fame. And she puzzled on life and just couldn't understand, till one day she just happened to look at her hand. And as she worked in the field, she pondered anew at the marvelous things that her own hand could do. Though she didn't know Jesus, no missionary had come. That day she vowed she would worship the God of her thumb. And as I reflected on this woman unknown, and that no TV crew would ever visit her home, I wondered how many her wisdom would shun, that she had found God by observing her thumb. As I continued to listen to the physicist's words, I had to admit it was all rather absurd, that in all of his knowledge and the research he'd done, he still couldn't see past the end. Chance to hear them both.